Each year, hundreds of thousands of unaccompanied youth from Central America travel in alarming numbers, seeking to reunite with their parents or hoping to find work to help support their families back home. Youth are mainly migrating from Honduras, El Salvador, and Guatemala to what is known as the Northern Triangle. For youth, lack of education and limited job opportunities are critical issues. Many of them will have been migrating for both employment and family reunification purposes. Carlos, who agreed to share his story, migrated because of poverty in his community and a lack of opportunity to gain an education.
Bueno, inicialmente creo que se debe bastante a la falta de educación, al acceso a la educación o a mejores oportunidades. Esas que tengan que ver con permanecer dentro del país. O sea, si un país no tiene esas condiciones, difícilmente pues la sociedad o los jóvenes van a estar aquí en el país.
Like many families in this community, Carlos lives with his mother in a shanty built from plastic sheets. There are no paved streets, no sewage system, no electricity or potable water. In order to one day get an education, Carlos thought he had to get away from poverty and leave home.
Me fui pues, no sentí yo que iba a ser tan peligroso, pero ya viajando, yo me di cuenta que no era fácil. Para mí fue difícil irme y saber que quizás no iba a regresar o me iba a estar bastante tiempo o me iba a pasar algo. Caminé bastante tiempo, cruzamos lugares donde no había gente y también me tocó dormir en lugares. Yo extrañaba mucho a mi mamá. Me había ido, pero no me había dado cuenta, pues, que toda la preocupación que le había dado a ella. Tal vez ella estaba con sus familiares o con sus amigas y quizás ella en la iglesia estaba orando.
Bueno, yo desde que él dijo que se iba, pues, al ver el viaje era como difícil. Porque él era mi único hijo. Muchos se habían ido y habían habido muertos. En partes que yo sabía que quedaba sola.
Carlos left in search of better opportunities. But in the end, he returned because he couldn't live so far from his homeland and his mother. He came back after 5 months.
Ya me había decidido regresarme porque no me sentía bien y porque extrañaba a mi país. Es mejor trabajar aquí en su país, buscar las oportunidades, así como estoy tratando yo ahora de hacer, sin necesidad de ir.
La familia es lo más importante y cuidarlo. Y uno como madre, pues lo mejor es luchar en su país que ir a perder su familia.
Approximately 60% of the population in Central America lives on less than $4 per day. Overall, 50% of the population lives below the poverty line. In the countryside, poverty rates are especially high, and almost 50% of households live in extreme poverty. They have limited access to good schools and job opportunities.
For irregular migration and immigration in general, we found that there are at least three causes. First one, it's violence at the communities, and the other one is, education, the less opportunities to have education, and the third one, the opportunities to find a job or to be engaged in something. The other issue that is big is the domestic violence. So in Nicaragua, we always say that it have like a woman phase of migrating because the woman just decides to travel and get out of Nicaragua because of that issue.
Many women migrants who travel become victims of human trafficking. Women are particularly vulnerable, and quite often they have been trafficked for the purpose of sexual exploitation. Maria, not her real name, was struggling financially to support her and her child when her neighbor offered a well-paying job abroad. She agreed, but had no idea what lay ahead.
Llegó una mujer ahí a la casa y me dice de que había una fábrica de zapatos. Entonces yo dije que para prosperar y salir adelante y comprar mi hogar, que de tanta pobreza, yo dije voy a irme. Ella dijo de que le diéramos los papeles porque ella nos iba a guardar. Era la cédula. Y entonces nosotros confiamos en ella porque nunca pensamos lo que los iba a hacer.
Soon after, she realized that she had been sold to a prostitution house and would be forced to work as a prostitute. Luckily, she managed to escape. Maria now lives with her 13-year-old daughter, who teaches her how to read and write. Maria believes the only way to prevent migration is providing education opportunities to youth. She hopes that her daughter will have a better future than herself by gaining an education.
Hubiera estudiado, por ejemplo, también hubieran estas oportunidades que hay ahorita. Me hubiera preparado y hubiera tenido mi buen trabajo, ¿verdad? No estuviera así.
Lucas was the oldest of three brothers, and because his father had left, he was the only breadwinner in the family. He made a difficult decision to leave the country, despite the fact that he was only 16 at the time.
Yo pensé en irme porque no encontré ya trabajo. El trabajo donde no estaba aquí, entré como en desesperación, que no quería estar aquí porque no tenía ni un córdoba, nada. Entonces, yo pensé que la solución sería irme para otro lado. Yo me fui, fue una madrugada que estaba mi mamá. Bueno, cuando me estaba despidiendo de ella, que yo me iba a ir, me detuvo, que no me fuera, que mejor esperáramos. Dios iba a componer todas las cosas. Pero despedirme porque dejar a la gente con la que yo me crié, no me quería ir, yo sentía que iba llorando.
Lucas traveled a couple of days, switching to multiple buses and walking long hours. He finally arrived in Costa Rica, where through a relative, he found a job on a farm. After several months, Lucas decided to go back to Nicaragua. He was no longer able to live away from his family.
Yo amo tanto estar en Nicaragua porque es el lugar donde yo nací, donde me he criado. A mí me gustaría aprender muchas cosas para ser alguien en la vida, en un futuro.
Lucas represents many youth in similar situations. Despite high levels of unemployment, poverty, and violence, youth in Central America can be optimistic about their future. They consider themselves leaders, but lack the decision-making power to make change. The PICMCA project, Preventing Irregular Child Migration in Central America, is known as CONFIO in Spanish, is being implemented by CCFC, Child Fund International, Educo, and supported by the Government of Canada. This four-year project is being operated in five Central American countries: El Salvador, Honduras, Mexico, Guatemala, and Nicaragua.
Project of Prevention of Irregular Child Migration in Central America and Mexico. It's a project that is regional. It's like $15 million, and this project tends to get to the root causes of irregular migration. So we also put in this project a lot of campaign and information about the risk of irregular migration and try to look for a solution at their own country instead of deciding to travel to other country.
PICMCA focuses on three key areas. First, by keeping children and youth safe through training at all levels. Secondly, improving employment opportunities for youth through vocational skills training and providing scholarships to youth. And third, improving youth leadership through youth forums, community awareness campaigns, and influencing government-level policy and program changes.
With this project, you will have opportunity of education. You will have opportunity to have a protection network, participating of the activities, participating of the changes you need at your community. So this project is not just giving protection to yourself, but it also give you opportunity to get a job and have a new opportunity to your life instead of just traveling or deciding to migrate again.
This regional project supports and inspires youth to focus more on their education. For example, HUPAC is a youth leadership program in Nicaragua. It creates a safe place for children to socialize and to study and training to prevent irregular child migration.
Hemos estado trabajando con niños, niñas, adolescentes en riesgo de migrar. Por ejemplo, a los adolescentes hemos estado haciendo convocatorias donde les podemos enseñar artesanía y cosas así, digamos, cómo hacer camisetas, cómo hacer gorra, emprendedurismo, para que ellos puedan conseguir un trabajo y así poder tener un mejor trabajo y no quieran migrar.
Que yo como adulta yo no sabía las informaciones, ahora yo las sé. Entonces nosotros, como yo como madre, se las paso a mis hijos. Entonces, hay muchos proyectos que le dan a los jóvenes oportunidades de estudiar, de prepararse y ser algo en la vida. Y antes, no, en mi tiempo, yo no lo tuve.
Yo creo que se necesita conocer más de sus derechos, de las oportunidades que hay en nuestro país de empleo, para que de esta manera podamos y puedan quedarse en sus casas y no emigrar a otros países.
All youth and parents that we have interviewed have only one wish: to stay in their country and get the opportunity to study and work in their own homeland. None of them want to leave the country, and PICMCA makes that possible.
Nosotros tenemos ese poder de poder cambiar nuestro futuro y de salir adelante en nuestro país.
Así como amo Nicaragua, así amo a mi familia. Pues el deseo mío es siempre estar juntos con ellos, no estar en otro lado.
Nunca me habían entrevistado así, que me desahogué todo lo que me ha pasado. Ya me siento como nueva y hay esperanzas que me dan para darle ánimo a mi hija y que siga adelante. Me siento agradecida con Dios y con ustedes.